Hello and welcome to another video with me, Christian Rauchenwald. Today I'm going to show you how you can buy your own custom domain at Namecheap. Before we get to that, I want to quickly point out, if you take anything positive away from this video, if it helps you with your problem, like buying a domain at Namecheap and setting it up, I'd appreciate if you subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out any future content and give a thumbs up to the video so other people know that it's valuable and helping. That said, if you run into any problems along the way, simply leave a comment below the video so I can help you out. Now let's get started and head to Namecheap. So once you are on the Namecheap website, maybe using the link in the description down below, the first thing you want to do is enter the domain that you want to buy. In my case, that's affiliatemarketingblueprints.com. As you can see, that domain is still available. So what I can do next is I simply add it to the cart. And the domain gets added to the cart and shows up on the right. It will offer you a bunch of extra options, but honestly, you don't need any of them. So you just click on the View Cart button to actually go to a summary of your cart. There you will see your domain again. You will be able to change the duration of the domain, how long you buy it for now already. You can activate auto renewal so it doesn't expire. And you can activate the free Whois guard because it will protect your personal information and avoiding annoying cold calls and cold emails from certain companies. That said, you can go through the rest of the option. You do not need the Gmail integration and stuff like that usually, but if you need it, you can buy it straight away here. Or you can check out my separate video on how to set up Google Suite with a 20% discount. You'll find the link in the description below or in a linked card that now appears in the top right corner of this video. Now that's pretty much all there is to this step of the process. Now, what you need to do is like simply scroll down and click on the confirm order button or click on the confirm order button on the right. On the next step, you're going to be able to sign in to your existing Namecheap account or sign up for a new Namecheap account. I'm going to forward this part of the video or actually cut out that part of the step to protect my personal data, and I'll see you on the next page. Now on the next page, it's about your personal contact information. So in case you're incorporated, you simply add your company name, your job title, and the address of your company. If you're not buying this domain for a company, simply enter your personal address and name, as well as your phone number down below for security reasons. Again, I'm going to skip this step so to not show my personal data, and I see you in the next step in a second. Next thing, you're going to see a summary of your current data, the information that you entered. It's going to be added as the contact information for your domain. Now, if you pick the Whois protection service, this information will not be available public, but it will be available to Namecheap. Also, when you scroll down on this page, you can pick to save those settings as your default settings for future purchases. And then at the bottom or at the right side, you just hit the continue button to go to the next page. As always, I've blurred out or skipped this part and didn't show the information I entered, but it's quite straightforward, so I see you in the next step. Now, in the next step, you can pick your payment method and you can either choose to pay with credit card or simply use your PayPal account for that. So just select which payment method you prefer, either secure card payment or PayPal, and follow the instructions on the screen. At the bottom of this page, you will have the option to activate automatic renewal for all of your domains so they never expire. I encourage you to check this checkbox before you hit the continue button either on the right or at the bottom of the page. Now the last page is going to be the order confirmation page where you can review your order. You will see your domain registration, the free Whois guard protection if you selected it, and at the bottom your billing address and payment method. If everything is as you want it to be, simply confirm your order by clicking the Pay Now button either at the bottom of the page or on the right hand side. Now your order is going to be processed, and if there are no issues with your payment method, you will eventually see the order confirmation dialog, basically your new Namecheap dashboard, where a short questionnaire will ask you about your experience with this order process. You're good to go, your domain is now set up within your Namecheap account. You would now need to manage it within Namecheap to point it to whatever service you want to use it for. But that's not the topic of this video. So thanks again for watching. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. And if you have any issues whatsoever, simply comment below. Till then, bye-bye.